The following presentation is brought to you by the University of Arkansas System, Division of Agriculture.
Primary funding for this research was provided by the USGA. Earthworms. From a horticultural standpoint, earthworms are typically considered beneficial.
They create macropores for air and water infiltration and root growth. They can help kind of move nutrients around, move soil around in the profile, and all of that is beneficial.
But when it comes to golf course management, uncontrolled earthworm activity can wreak havoc.
Casting on the golf courses can cause issues with ball roll and playability from a golfer standpoint, and then from a management standpoint, you can get muddy surfaces, weed and disease pressure on your turf.
Earthworm casts also have the potential to interfere with and even damage turf care equipment. The primary earthworm control method, utilized until the mid-20th century, was developed by a British greenskeeper named Peter W. Lees in the 1890s. Lees discovered that application of mora meal, which contains a class of natural surfactants called saponins, irritated earthworms and caused them to rise to the turf's surface where they could be manually removed. Around the 1950s, synthetic, worm-toxic pesticides entered the market and led to a decrease in the application of Lees removal methods. Growing concerns for human health and the environment, however, led the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency to discontinue these pesticides.
There are no pesticides that are labeled for earthworm control, so applying anything to kill earthworms on your turf would be illegal.
Other cultural control methods, including application of acidifying fertilizers and removal of clippings, have given sometimes positive but overall inconclusive results. Chemical expellents similar to Lee's mora meal are also in development, but are not yet labeled for use on earthworms. Although studies have shown that these expellents can be effective, long-term consequences of their use are unknown, not to mention the immediate ecological dangers posed to wildlife, especially to aquatic populations. And finally, the harm done to otherwise beneficial earthworm populations is not ideal. Recent research has demonstrated that sand top dressing can deter earthworms and reduce earthworm casting on golf course surfaces. However, the effects of top dressing have not always been consistent. Building on this research, the University of Arkansas Department of Horticulture undertook a study to determine the combined effects of root zone soil texture and long-term sand top dressing application rates on earthworm casting activity. This study, performed at the University of Arkansas Agricultural Research and Extension Center in Fayetteville, Arkansas, utilized Patriot Bermuda grass maintained at a length of 1/2 inch. These experimental plots were previously used in a study that investigated 4 combinations of root zone soil texture and sand top dressing application rates over a period of 7 years. The 4 combinations include a native Captina silt loam soil root zone, lightly top dressed at a rate of 0.25 inches of sand per year, the same native soil root zone, heavily top dressed at a rate of 1 inch of sand per year, a sand root zone, lightly top dressed at a rate of 0.25 inches of sand per year, and a sand root zone, heavily top dressed at a rate of 1 inch of sand per year. All 4 combinations were replicated 4 times for a total of 16 plots. Each plot measured 5 feet wide by 16 feet long. Over the course of 2 years, from November 2015 through October 2017, researchers measured volumetric soil moisture content and soil temperature, and conducted cast counts at least twice per month for each combination of soil root zone texture and top dressing rate. Volumetric soil moisture content was measured using a Spectrum Field Scout TDR-300 soil moisture meter at a depth of 3 inches, while soil temperature was measured at a depth of about 4 inches. In order to quantify cast counts, researchers used a standard tally counter to record the total number of casts found in all 16 plots. To avoid double counting any casts, plots were subdivided while collecting data using a 5x5-foot frame, which was further subdivided into 1x1-foot squares. After each data collection event, casts were cleared away either by mowing or with a draggable cocoa mat to reset the experimental plots for the next observation period. The average weekly cast counts from each experimental block were averaged by month, and comparisons were made between each combination of soil root zone texture and top dressing rate. Cast counts were also analyzed relative to soil moisture and temperature to evaluate any correlations between casting activity and these environmental parameters. In April of 2017, a shop vac was used to collect earthworm casts from experimental plots, which were dried, ground, sieved, and analyzed to determine particle size distribution and percent organic matter. Soil from each experimental plot was also collected for particle size distribution analysis and percent organic matter determination. Upon completion of this study, University of Arkansas researchers were able to make several observations regarding earthworm activity on golf courses. There was generally very little casting activity on the lightly top-dressed soil root zone plots. In the soil root zone, heavy top dressing typically resulted in significantly greater casting activity. In the sand root zone, top dressing rate did not impact casting activity, except during the fall of 2017, when casting activity was significantly greater under a light top dressing regimen. A comparison of moisture content with cast counts demonstrated that there was no statistically significant correlation between the two factors. Soil temperature was found to be a significant predictor of earthworm casting activity, explaining 10 to 34% of the observed variation in cast counts. The critical root zone temperatures for peak casting activity were determined to be between 11.1 degrees Celsius and 14.5 degrees Celsius across all four experimental variations. And, contrary to hypothesis, this study's analysis of the collected soil samples from each root zone and top dressing combination suggests that there is no correlation between root zone organic matter content and casting activity in Patriot Bermuda grass. Another factor that plays a role in casting activity on golf courses is the species of earthworms that reside in the affected turf grass system. To better understand the effect that earthworm species may have on casting activity and control efforts, researchers collected earthworm samples from the study location. 1 by 1 foot sections of turf were extracted from each experimental plot to a depth of 8 inches. Earthworm samples were also gathered during surveys of 5 golf courses in the surrounding region. Researchers separated the subsoil layer from the root zone and sorted through each sample by hand, collecting any earthworms found for later identification. Morphological identification was conducted on some earthworm samples, but due to the small size or developmental immaturity of many of the collected samples, species could typically not be identified using taxonomic keys. Therefore, a DNA testing methodology was devised. Earthworm samples were cleaned and boiled to quickly kill the sample while preserving the earthworm's tissue. A small amount of DNA was then obtained using a proprietary DNA extraction kit. And a polymerase chain reaction was used to multiply the DNA sample. Each DNA sample was then sent to Eurofins Genomics for DNA sequencing. Analysis of the resulting DNA sequences found that a majority of the collected samples were from the Diplocardia genus, which is native to North America. The difference in earthworm abundance between the heavily top-dressed sand and soil root zones was not statistically significant. The light top-dressing soil root zone treatment was found to have the greatest overall abundance of earthworms, despite exhibiting the least amount of casting activity. Possible explanations for this discrepancy include differences in species abundance, a higher percentage of juvenile earthworms compared to adults, and the possibility that the more favorable soil root zone environment allowed earthworms to focus energy expenditures on reproduction instead of foraging and biomass production. Additional research on earthworm activity must be performed to better understand how variations in turfgrass species, maintenance practices, topdressing application rates, and earthworm species will affect casting activity.
Hopefully future research can kind of help nail down a specific recommendation. You're kind of limited in what you can do to control earthworms right now, and so you need to kind of be patient with your superintendents as they kind of figure out what is going to work.
Golf course superintendents seeking to control excessive earthworm activity should be aware that sand top dressing may impact surface casting, but results from this study varied over time and may be further influenced by other factors.
So it's hard to recommend one top dressing treatment over another, you know, heavy or light, because it depends on your root zone, it depends on the year. Different years you could see different effects, so it's hard to make one concrete recommendation.
This study suggests that light top dressing on a native soil root zone may reduce casting activity, while top dressing rate on a sand capped root zone may not have significant effect on earthworm casting. And overall, there was significantly greater casting activity on the sand capped root zones compared with the lightly top dressed soil root zone. For more information about this study or the University of Arkansas Department of Horticulture and their research program and projects, please contact Dr. Wayne McKay. Primary funding for this research was provided by the USGA.
Additional funding for this research was provided by a gift from the Arkansas Turfgrass Association and from the Arkansas Golf Course Superintendents Association.